From inside Rogers Center in downtown Toronto, the show has an AL East matchup. It's the Baltimore Orioles and the Toronto Blue Jays. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. All right, just about ready for baseball. And towing the slab here, Jose Berríos. Singing, he's managed to rack up a lot of innings on the mound this season.
And Boog, this guy's getting close to 200 innings on the year. You know, there's some milestones that pitchers go after. One of them, 20 wins. But another one that we don't talk about a whole lot is that 200-inning threshold. To be able to surpass that leading says that, hey, they prepared themselves for the season. They were able to stay healthy, Cedric. And they were able to pitch effectively enough to stay in ball games long enough to reach that number. Pretty impressive on what he's done, and it's not over yet.
Cedric Mullins leading off here as he looks at that one outside the zone.
707.
Kicks and fires. Good eye right there. Well, the Blue Jays have seemed to go all in on players with MLB dads. What about those advantages, guys that have been around the clubhouse a lot?
They are not afraid. Being in an intense game, 40,000, 50,000 people screaming, that's like being in the backyard for these guys that have grown up with a big league dad coming to the ballpark all the time. So they're very comfortable in this environment.
The pitch. And now it's filled up. That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches. And somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. Strike in there. Throw to second and great jump.
Well, he's batting leadoff and he's acting like a traditional leadoff hitter. Gets on base to start the game, then puts himself on second with a nice stolen bag. I think that sets the tone for the offense for sure.
Mullins at second with nobody out. Through that, and it's a strikeout. One away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Ramon Urias.
And now the shortstop, Ramon Urias. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle to base hit. Mullins rounds third, headed for the plate. Throw is offline and he scores. And it's 1-0.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Here's Ryan Mountcastle. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Kicks and deals. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And that lands in no man's land, a foul ball.
Well, he missed a hittable off-speed pitch right there. Not sure exactly with the timing. Sometimes you get a backup breaking ball. You're expecting it to make its move at the inning.
Slings to second, on to first, double play, and that's the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 1-0. Bottom of the first, and getting the start for Baltimore, Zach Plesac.
Well, last time out, picked up the win, didn't allow a run, pitched extremely well. He doesn't have to be perfect, but if he can give another performance like last time out, his team will be happy.
We go to the bottom of the first. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Bo Bichette. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. Right side, Mountcastle
over to pick it up.
Steps on first for the out. Let's take a look at the lineup. In that leadoff spot, a guy they're looking to get going, Bo Bichette.
Yeah, Boog, he just hasn't been himself at all lately. I mean, it's hard to know if it's mechanical, if it's mental. It's just a struggle all the way around. It's something that everybody goes through. I think the key is you've got to stick to the process. You've got to focus on every pitch, and don't worry about the result. Take it one pitch at a time, one at bat at a time.
Raimel Tapia in the box with one away as he takes one there for a ball. Next offering is in for a strike. Foul ball there. Swing and a slow roller. Odor gloves it over to first. Here tonight, an efficient start to the home first, two away.
Batting third, the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Here's Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Vladdy hitting better against right-handers this year, so some reverse splits there. That one's in there, 0-1. Righty to the plate. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Real ugly 0-1 swing right there. As a pitcher, got to be hunting for that strikeout. Keep him off balance. Send him back to the dugout.
Next offering misses. And it's 1-2.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
And a pitch. A foul ball, he stays alive. And the right-hander deals. He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. Mullins settles underneath it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Blue Jays go down in order. They're down 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, Anthony Santander at the plate.
Leading off for Baltimore, the right fielder, Anthony Santander.
The wind to kick the pitch. Check swing, and that's a ball. Not even close there. Now 2-0.
2-0 count. You really don't want to give in here. You've got to work the edges. Really execute a pitch. Hopefully you can get back into this count.
Swing and a line drive caught.
Batting sixth, the left fielder, Austin Hayes.
And now it's Austin Hayes. Hayes having more success against left-handed pitching this season, as might be expected. Next pitch downstairs. Ball one.
Now it's 1-0.
And a 1-0. Look out!
Yep,
and it hit him.
Well, that one might sting for a bit, but it helps the team and it boosts the OBP boog. Sometimes that trade-off is worth it, but sometimes it's not.
Now it's DJ Stewart. First offering, and it just misses. Hayes, the base runner at first with one out. Next offering upstairs. Gary Simmons has the plate duty in this one.
Well, with Simmons, it's not always your standard strike zone boog. It kind of gives a little extra in some parts of the zone and then can be tighter in others. But I think the important thing is he doesn't get labeled as inconsistent. So you got to stay ready up there.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Yeah, one of those umpires, you just have to know what to expect, right?
Exactly.
The 2-1. Swings through that one for strike two. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two down. Rougned Odor comes up to the plate now.
The second baseman, Rougned Odor.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two outs. There's a strike. In the air, center field, and that is Springer. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that'll do it. And the Orioles leave one, but they still lead it 1-0. Back now in Toronto. We head to the bottom of the second. Here's the center fielder, George Springer.
The center fielder.
Here comes a pitch.
Springer.
That one clips the outside corner. 1-1. Please set. A guy that really fills up the strike zone. Rarely walks people. The downside is the home run ball more likely in play. And the pitch. And a foul ball.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Next offering down low and in the dirt.
Well, pitchers like this usually work down in the zone a lot, but these days with all the uppercut swings most hitters are taking to elevate the ball, pitchers almost have to be effective up in the zone with hard stuff. So maybe that's one area he can improve in his game to try to combat that long ball.
That misses. It's 2-2. Stays alive.
A little early on that fastball. I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch on this next one.
And he deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. And now the count filled up 3-2. As a hitter, does knowing that this guy's going to be in the zone, does that make you more aggressive?
Kind of, but you still have to stay on that backside. You've got to make sure you get pitch recognition and let your hands work.
Hit hard. That gets through.
Well, he really had to battle for that one. Man, that was so fun to watch. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. In there, and it's 0-1. Did you ever really need a cue to be more aggressive?
No, I never did. especially when it comes to messing with you.
Wow. Plesak a throw over. And Springer's in there safely. Next pitch misses. And a count even, 1-1. Rolled to short. Possible two ball. Urias tossed to second. How about that double play?
That is good. The right
nice soft hands on the backhand right there in the sixth hole. Starts the double play. That's not an easy throw, but he puts it on the money. Really good job to get that double play started.
And now Teoscar Hernandez. In there for strike one. Right-hander kicks, deals. Little chopper rolls foul. The pitch. Hit high in the air. There it goes. See ya. Teoscar Hernandez hits one out. His 32nd of the year. And we're all square. It's tied at one.
No matter how this outing ends, that pitch is going to haunt him for a while. An 0-2 mistake. That's supposed to be a pitch out of the zone. He left it in the spot that the hitter could do some damage with, and that's exactly what he did.
Here's Matt Chapman.
Batting seven. The third baseman, Matt.
They say he went.
Chapman.
Up the middle, he dives, but he can't make the catch. No throw, and the defense comes away with nothing.
Batting it, the catcher, McGuire.
So two down, Reese McGuire next up for the Blue Jays. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Got him. Good job of damage control right there. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. All even now at 1-1. On to the third inning, and here's the catcher, Jacob Nottingham.
Leading off for the Orioles, the catcher, number 13.
Berríos, back to work.
Nottingham.
That's in there, and it's 0-1. Next offering way off the plate. Next one misses, and it's 2-1.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
There's a swing and a drive. Back there. He leaves the yard to right, and the Orioles jump out in front. It's 2-1.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
So up next, Cedric Mullins.
Now batting, the center fielder, Cedric
And first offering is fouled off.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And it's off the wall. And that's a double.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way. But well, that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field.
So digging in, Toby Welch. Check on the runner, and he's back safely. That one's in there, 0-1. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. That's strike two.
Everyone can have a little chuckle there. He's had such a great season. Rarely ever do you see that kind of swing.
And the 0-2.
One ball, two strikes. Down.
Mullins leads off second with nobody out. And down on strikes he goes. And one away in the top of the third. And the batter will be the shortstop, Ramon Urias.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Move to second, and he's back in there. Soft contact in the air. Biggio makes the play. Out number two.
Now batting, the first baseman, Ryan Mountcastle.
Ryan Mountcastle, the next to hit. And the first offering is not close. That hits the dirt. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
After giving up that home run earlier, it just doesn't seem like he wants to challenge him.
Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know these 2-0 counts, Boo. They're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that. But ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
And ball four to a board.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Now first and second, two down. Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Anthony Santander. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, he looks fresh out there, just needs to get a little more confidence and remember how good he's been in the past.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Next offering is foul back. The pitch. That one missed.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
One, two now. And now 2-2. First and second, two down. Next offering is down low.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
The pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Here's the left fielder, Austin Hayes. In there for strike one.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Oh, right to the backstop. Next offering is foul back. Righty delivers. And it's fouled away. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at bat. Kicks and deals.
Three ball, two strikes.
And there's ball four.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the walk. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Now here's the Orioles DH, DJ Stewart.
Well, there's a reason why he's at the bottom of the order, struggling as of late, but a knock here would be a huge lift for him and for his team.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Bodie Francis, the rookie right-hander, is getting loose. Stripling getting loose as well. And the righty deals. That one fouled off.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
Mountcastle on third. Santander over at second. Hayes at first. Two out of the inning. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss. And that is that. We head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Orioles 3 and the Blue Jays 1. Yeah. Who that in the whip? Yeah, you know it's me. Yeah. You can't stop my shine. I'm just doing. And welcome back. Set for the bottom of the third. Kevin Biggio up to the plate.
For Toronto. The second
well, after
baseman.
Putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across. This is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And there's the strike.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
And a pitch. Taps softly to the right side. And they put the tag on him for the out.
The batter number 11. Shortstop. Go.
Bo Bichette up to the dish. It's amazing. We get a chance to talk to a lot of opposing managers. This guy scares managers on the other team as much as anyone.
And he gets to fly beneath the radar with the other more recognizable names in this lineup.
And a foul ball. One down, base is empty. Now a check swing, but he held up. Fouls one off, 2-2. In the air, right field. Santander should have this one. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Up next for the Blue Jays, the left fielder, Raimel.
Raimel Tapia up to hit.
Tapia.
That hits the dirt. Ball one. Next pitch is outside.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball makes the count 2-1.
With two out and nobody on, you want to go right after this guy. He's the number two hitter, which means if he gets on, you've got some thunder coming up behind him.
The 2-1. Line drive, drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down.
And that hit carries a little extra meaning, Boog. It keeps his hitting streak going. He is dialed in at the dish right now.
I don't think there's a more confident hitter in all of baseball right now. Looks like he's expecting a knock every time he steps to the plate. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. now. First offering misses badly for ball one. Plesak a throw over, and he dives back in safely. The pitch. And that one is in for a strike.
Well, he left that changeup up. Got away with one there, and he'll take it, but doesn't want to make that mistake again.
Runner takes off. Pitch misses. Throw safe.
Well, that steal right there is wanting to take advantage of having a really good hitter at the plate. Now they've got a much better shot at bringing home a two-out RBI.
Runner leads away at second. That's down and in. Strike two.
That front door slider is such a devastating pitch. You don't want to get beat by the inside fastball, so you cheat a little bit, and then by the time it gets there, it's out of the swing plane.
Tying run at the plate. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
I don't think you really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Here's George Springer.
Number four.
Springer, an RBI machine this year. Right near the top of the league leaderboard as the season winds down. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Good pitch right there. Anytime you can get one by a bat of this caliber, especially with runners on, it's got to give you some confidence out there on the mound that you can win this battle.
At the belt and fires. And a foul ball. Here's the 0-2.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
And the next pitch is way outside. Tapia on second. Guerrero on at first with two down. Springer swings through that one. It's a strikeout. That is the inning. Blue Jays leave a pair, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Back here at Rogers Center, now it's the second baseman, Rougned Odor.
The second baseman, Rougned Odor.
A wind and the pitch. That one's in there. That's strike one. Righty to the plate. And it's 1-1. Slapped foul. That one ran inside, almost got him. And a swing and a miss. One up, one down. And now the catcher comes up to him. Jacob Nottingham.
Jacob Nottingham.
And that's in there for strike one. Next offering is in the dirt. Kicks and fires. And that one fouled off. One and two here. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. That misses the zone, and the count is even, 2-2. Nottingham tries to hold up, appeal to first, and he went around. Rule to swing. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
And here is Cedric Mullins. That hits the dirt, and it's 1-0.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
On the ground, right side. Biggio picks it up, sends it to first, and they get Mullins for the out. And that is that. To the bottom of inning number four now. It's the Orioles 3 and the Blue Jays 1. Welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. And now for the Jays, Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
The designated hitter, Lourdes Gurriel.
And the right-hander back to work. Close, but called a ball. And that's ball one. The next pitch misses, 2-0.
He hasn't wanted to challenge him. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
Next pitch inside, and that's ball three. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's the strike.
I think he was sitting off speed right there because he just let the fastball go by.
Hard ground ball, base knock.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like you did right there.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Next offering misses, 1-1. Here comes a pitch. Nobody out, runner at first. Swing and a base hit. Throw comes in, runner stopped, second and third, nobody out.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling.
They got a pitch he could drive, but he didn't get too excited like a lot of guys do and pull off the baseball. Really good timing all the way through the swing, and the barrel was so on plane with the ball. Easy drive into the gap for that double.
You can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Up the middle, base hit, one run is in. Another comes in to score, it's 3-3.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. Just kept it simple, played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Reese McGuire next up for the Blue Jays. He was a strikeout
now
victim his first
catcher,
time.
Reese.
He swings and fouls one off. And a pitch.
That's a ball.
That's in there. 1-2.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
Got him looking. And there's one down.
Well, you could tell he wasn't expecting that ball to break back in on him. He may have been looking for something away, maybe something soft. But that slider on the inside corner absolutely frozen.
Kevin Biggio with a chance to hit. First offering misses the mark. Whoa. The next offering misses, and now 2-0.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity, try to get a rollover, something on the ground, stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
And he deals. Ground ball right side, could be two. There's one, and it's a double play to end the inning. On to the top of the fifth we go. All tied up and three apiece. Back here at the ballpark, top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Toby Welk.
The third baseman, number 10.
The wide to kick the pitch. And takes low for ball one.
Count 1-0.
Next pitch misses. Two balls, no strikes.
Struggled a little bit in this one. Couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
And now 2-1.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it, it's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Clearly hoping he could get a swing and miss on that, but doesn't fool the hitter with that breaking ball. Nice job, just couldn't keep it fair.
And a liner out into right center for a base hit.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
So next to hit for Baltimore, Ramon Urias. First offering way inside, almost got him. Barrios a check to first, and he just got his hand in there. And the right-hander deals.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
Well, gets his lead at first with nobody out. Next offering is in for a strike.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
The pitch. And that one hit to first. And it's through for a hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Well, that may end up being an at bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
And the batter now, Ryan Mountcastle. First pitch doesn't find the zone. First and second here, no outs. Next pitch downstairs, and the count is 2-0. And the righty deals. In the air, left field. Tapia makes the catch, and there's one away.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Two on, one out. Anthony Santander, the next to hit for the Orioles. foul ball.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Here's the 0-1. And a good eye there. One out. Runners at first and second. A 1-2. Got him looking. And two away now.
Just locked him up right there for the second out, and that's a little bat he's probably going to be thinking about for a little while. Didn't pull the trigger. Not how you want to go down in an RBI spot, so now you got to hope your teammate behind you can pick you up.
Now the left fielder, Austin Hayes. First pitch, not close.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
And a pitch. There's a strike. And now two balls and a strike. Hernandez on his way over. And here it comes. Pulls that one foul. Next one misses, and the count is filled up. Stays alive. Two on, two outs, and fouled off. Two outs, and they're all loaded up. Go ahead, run on base. Next is the designated hitter, DJ Stewart. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Hit weakly on the ground. Sends it to first. Out number three. Orioles leave them loaded. Still tied 3-3. It ain't no surprise. A full moon sits in the sky. You better watch your... Bottom of the inning. Now here's the leadoff man for the Blue Jays, Bo Bichette.
Leading up for Toronto, the shortstop, Bo.
The right-hander back to work. That's in for a strike. Activity in the bullpen for Baltimore. D.L. Hall appears to be getting loose. Lopez warming up as well. The pitch. Strike two.
You tie a guy up like that, you're feeling like you are in command.
The pitch. That one misses, and the count is 1-2. In the air out to center, Mullins moving under it. puts it away for the out.
Now batting, left fielder, Rival Tapia.
Now the number two hitter, Raimel Tapia. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The next pitch misses, and that's ball two.
Two balls, no strike.
Next pitch is downstairs. Here's a 3-0. There's a strike.
Clearly taking all the way there in that 3-0 count. It was a cookie right down the middle.
And that one is lifted in the air. Santander brings it in. Two up, two down.
Now batting, first baseman, Vladimir.
So up next for Toronto, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Now be careful with this guy. He's got power. He can untie it with one swing. Foul ball there. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes, even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
0-2 now. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Fought off foul. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. So no change in the score. It's 3-3. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Bodie Francis. He's pitching on 2 days rest.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm. Coming out of the bullpen, we'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back now in Toronto, here's the second baseman, Rougned Odor. The wind of the pitch. And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes. Left-hand batter waits.
That's ball two. 2-0.
There's a strike.
Count was 2-1.
Big swing and a miss.
Two.
And there's a ball. Right-handed reliever. And that one fouled off. Ripped on a line. He makes the grab, and there's one down.
The catcher, number 13, Jacob Nottingham.
And next for the Orioles, Jacob Nottingham. pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Trevor Richards getting loose out there. Garcia, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. There's a strike.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Swing and a miss. And a count one and two.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Next offering way off the plate. Next one misses. Counts full, three and two. The kick, the 3-2. The punch out there, and there's two down.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
Cedric Mullins, the next to hit for the Orioles. And there's a foul ball. Righty delivers. That misses. And one and one. The wind of the pitch. And that misses off the outside edge. That one the other way. This looks like extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he's got his second double of the game.
Two hits for him in this one, both for extra bases. Got to feel good about that. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Toby Welk, the next to hit for the Orioles, and he's already singled in this game. Next offering is down low, and that's ball one. Mullins at second with two down. Next offering is in for a strike. Kicks and deals. And that's outside. The 2-1. And a strike. Two outs and one in scoring position. Down. And that is that. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. All tied up at three apiece. Back down for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound. D.L. Hall.
Number 50, D.L. Hall.
Well, we go bottom six. Leading off, George Springer.
Leading up for Toronto, the center fielder, Joel.
And a pitch.
Springer.
Ball one there.
Well, a mistake right here could untie this ball game. If you're the pitcher out there, you just want to be a little more cautious.
The 1-0.
2-0.
To the left side, but it is well foul. And a pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2. The next offering misses, and now it's 3-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but it's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
Springer swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Now one away.
Toughest pitch to hit. Fastball on the outer black. Man, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
The designated hitter, Lourdes Gurriel.
And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. On the ground to third. Gets it to first. Two up, two down.
The batter, the right fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the right fielder, Teoscar Hernandez. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Activity in the bullpen. Keegan Aiken, a lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. Lopez getting cranked up as well. The 0-1. And that skips in the dirt. That one misses. 2-1. To the right side, and it finds its way through for a hit, and that gives Matt Chapman a chance to hit with two out.
Up next to the Blue Jays, the third baseman, Matt.
And here is Chapman. Matt Chapman. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
That one's in there, 0-1. And now it's even up. Kicks and fires. On the ground, Odor handles, gathers, and throws to first. And that will end the inning. Seventh inning coming up. All tied up at 3 apiece. Back here at Rogers Center. And now the shortstop, Ramon Urias.
Leading off for the Orioles, the shortstop, Ramon Urias.
The pitch. And that's through there for a strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. The 0-2. Line drive, base hit.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
No outs. Runner at first. Digging in, Ryan Mountcastle. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. And the right-hander deals. Ripped, but it curls foul. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Cut on and missed. Transfer bobbled, and there's no throw. The 1-2. That one hit to right. And that'll fall for a base hit. Throw to second. Not in time. He's there easily.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with two strikes. I think he choked up a little bit. Maybe spread out. But he got the job done right there.
Now, Anthony Santander. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field, way back there, and it's off the wall. Way up the line, and the run scores.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Put a really nice balanced swing on it, and when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box, and he'll feel real good about that one.
So up next, Austin Hayes. In there, and it's 0-1.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Fouled off. He was late. Two runners in scoring position. Nobody out. Got him. That's the first out in the top of the seventh.
Well, it can be so tough as a hitter to pull yourself out of an extended slump, one that lasts for several games, even a week or more. You know, right now, he's really in one, so I'm sure his mind is all over the place, racing, having a hard time sleeping, trying to figure out what can get him back on track, back to feeling more comfortable and settled in the box.
And into the box for Baltimore, DJ Stewart. First pitch, and he just misses. Mountcastle at third. Santander over at second with one down. Next pitch inside, and a count 2-1. At the belt and fires. Fouls one off, 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. And another ball.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
And he walked him.
Almost a coin flip for the umpire in that call, but most umpires just don't want to give pitchers a break up in the zone like that.
And now here is Rougned Odor.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
In there for strike one.
Well, in this situation with runners on, you've got to get ahead in the count so that you can dictate the rest of the at-bat. Nice job right there.
The pitch. That's off the mark. One ball, one strike.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next pitch downstairs, and it's 2-1.
Brooke, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Bases loaded, one away. Next pitch misses outside. Three balls and a strike. Righty to the plate. Now this is in the air down the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Runner tagging from third. He'll score on the sac fly, and they take a two-run lead.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Trevor Richards into the game, and he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 33, Trevor Richards.
Here's the catcher to hit, Jacob Nottingham. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo home run, but an important swing of the bat in this game. We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, a come-and-get-me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
Next offering upstairs.
One ball, one strike.
Next one misses. Ball two.
Almost got him to commit, but he held back.
Here comes a pitch. Swings through that one.
They can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Next pitch is outside. And the righty deals. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. And a swing and a miss. The hat trick. Inning over, and it could have been worse. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Orioles 5 and the Blue Jays 3. And welcome back. Here's Reese McGuire.
Leading up for Toronto, the catcher.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Right through there for a strike.
Well, a good breaking ball like that can buckle the hitter, and by the time you realize it's going to be in the strike zone, it's too late to pull the trigger.
The 0-1. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Hayes makes the catch, and there's one down.
Now batting, the second baseman, Kevin Biggio.
Stepping in, Kevin Biggio. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike. Next pitch is popped up. Urias has a bead on it and puts the squeeze on that. Two down.
The batter number 11, shortstop, Bo.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Blue Jays lineup. Bo Bichette next up for the Blue Jays. Next offering is down low. Ball one. Next one misses. Now 2-0. Next offering misses, and that's ball three. Three oh down. And he takes a strike.
Three balls, one strike.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, you get a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Tapia at the plate now. That's ball one. Next offering is in for a strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And 1-2.
He's been able to go inside as well as outside, effectively working both sides of the plate in this at bat.
Got him swinging, and that's the inning. One left for Toronto. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. Ready to begin the eighth. Now here is Cedric Mullins.
For the Orioles, the center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
And a pitch. Little chopper rolls foul. Oh, and two as he waves at that one. Movement in the bullpen. Tim Meza getting ready to go. Garcia warming up as well. And a pitch. And it's fouled away. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth. So next to hit for Baltimore, Toby Welch.
Number 10.
It's interesting he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Pitch. And that one just missed off the outside edge. That misses. Full count now. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. Up next for the Orioles, Ramon Urias.
Ramon Uriah.
That one's in there, 0-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. Gonna count 1-2. Well, leads off first with one away. In the dirt. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. That's the second out.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age, sometimes too much information. But the guys that can take that information, process it, and then go out there, Boog, and execute the pitch, go right after that hitter, and get the result that they were anticipating, that's really good pitching right there. And it's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
Now move to first.
No,
well, back on a dive. Two outs. So two balls and no strikes.
2-0 count to a guy like this at the plate, you've got to throw a pitcher's pitch. Don't just try to get a strike. He could make you pay.
Right-handed reliever. Pitch misses, and that's ball three. And he deals. There's a strike. The pitch. And a foul ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
In the air, right field. Hernandez under this one and puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. One left for the Orioles as they hang on to their 5-3 lead. Now on the bump, Tyler Wells.
Now pitching,
and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
68, Tyler Wells.
On to the bottom of the eighth. And now for the Jays, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Leading up for Toronto, the first baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
A wind of the pitch. There's a strike.
Well, they say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. He's a little bit more confident to move to the at-bat.
Next one off the plate inside. And the count is 1-1. Next pitch is outside. That one hammered left field. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And it'll be George Springer to step to the plate. First offering, and it just misses. And now 2-0. Next offering is downstairs. Yep. Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. Slider clips the zone. The 3-1. And a foul ball. And here it comes. And that one fouled off. Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. And he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Here's Gurriel.
Now back, the designated hitter, Lourdes Gurriel.
Nope. First offering misses the mark. But why to kick the pitch? And downstairs.
He was a little out front, but did a good job keeping the hands back long enough to foul that pitch off.
Next offering clips the zone count even at two. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Down in order go the Blue Jays. They're still down 5-3. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Tim Mayza. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Mayza.
Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. And into the box for Baltimore, Anthony Santander.
Anthony Santander.
And a pitch. Good eye right there. Toronto's bullpen with some action. Julian Merriweather up and loosening in the pen. Garcia getting loose as well. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike. Kicks and deals. 3-2 now. And a pitch. That smash towards center. Springer there makes the catch. One down.
Now batting the left fielder, Austin.
And now it's going to be Austin Hayes. A strikeout and a walk. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Now batting, designated hitter, DJ.
Now it's the DH, Stewart. DJ Stewart. Nope. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. The lefty to 1-0. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. And now the lefty. Line drive. Calls it in, 2-0.
The bat, the second baseman, Rougned
Odor, the next to hit for the Orioles. Next offering is down low. 1-0. Next one is off the plate. And that's ball two. Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. And that one wrapped foul. Hayes leads off first with two down to the inning. Not close with that one, and it's 3-2. And ball four to a board.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
So first and second with two outs. So next to hit for Baltimore, Jacob Nottingham. That hits the dirt, and that is ball one. The pitch. He was late there. Strike one. And that's downstairs and outside. Next pitch misses way outside. And a 3-1 on the way. And that's ball four.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Next to hit, Cedric Mullins.
Kind of goes without saying, but stranding these two runners in scoring position right here, it feels like it's a must if they stand a chance to win this game.
Bounce to third. That ends the frame. So they load the bases, but leave them stranded. 6-7-8 scheduled to start the bottom of the ninth. It's the Orioles 5 and the Blue Jays 3. Welcome back, and here comes the closer, Cole Sulcer. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
Cole Sulcer.
Now it's going to be Teoscar Hernandez. He launched a solo shot back in the second inning of this one.
Yeah, that was big for these guys early on. Definitely helped them get off on the right foot.
The pitch. Swings through that.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
And the next pitch is way outside. And that one in the air center field. Mullins sizing this one up. One up, one down.
Up next to the Blue Jays, the third baseman, Matt Chapman.
Now Matt Chapman at the plate. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Righty delivers. Chapman gets a piece there. And fouled off.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Here comes a pitch. And it's even up.
Two and two.
And now the count filled up 3-2. Kicks and fires. High fly ball, pretty well struck out towards right center. And that one hops the wall. It's a double, third hit of the night for him.
Oh, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
Reese McGuire next up for the Blue Jays.
Now batting, the catcher, Reese.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
All season long, he's racked up a number of saves, and sometimes the adrenaline doesn't get high enough until there's a runner or two on base.
Next pitch way upstairs. Runner at second here, one gone. The 2-0 is in for a strike. The tying run at the plate. That one misses, and now 3-1. And the right-hander deals. There's a strike. Chapman, the runner at second with one away. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
Now batting, second baseman,
Kevin Biggio, getting ready to hit.
Well, you got the number 9-hole hitter right here, looking to do whatever he can to get on base, turn this lineup over so the best hitters in this lineup have a chance to tie up the ball game or maybe even walk it off.
And that's in there for strike one.
Well, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him in this situation. Very capable of getting a ground ball and getting out of this little jam.
The 0-2. Got him! And there's two away.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in, not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
Bo Bichette gets a chance to hit. And That first offering is fouled off. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
In the air, right side, and he's got it. Ball game, and the Orioles take game one of the series on the road.
It's always nice to grab the opener of a series. You come into a new ballpark, and just sometimes things aren't as comfortable as what you've been used to. The mound doesn't look straight. The background isn't what you like, but they didn't let any of those things distract them. In fact, they looked like they were playing a home game. Excellent job to set the tone for this series.
A 5-3 final score in this one. As the Orioles win this one, for Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long. Canary yellow diamond in the pinky ring. I kiss it, keep it so exquisite, bro. Official, we on the mission. We the titcher. You the toilet paper, gone and flush it. Told the baddest man to hit the hand. I had to go and touch it. Yeah, rolling through the city, got the radio.
Our final line score tonight: first for the victorious Orioles, 5 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 15 runners on base. For the Blue Jays, 3 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 5 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.